Hi guys. So, one of the biggest slaps in the face for us normies, I guess, is when that which has been sold to us as, the pinnacle of achievement, this idea that if you gain a lot of riches and make a lot of happy money, that's where the happiness lies, yeah. Because this is what our mass consumer society is running on. And I mean, anybody who's come across Johnny Cash's Hurt, I mean, it's amazing how he expresses it in there, isn't it? He says, I would give you my empire of dirt for another few hours with my wife, basically, who he lost, yeah, who's bemoaning. Interesting as well, you got this, who is it? Is it Dionysus? Is it the Green Man? I don't know. Is it a lust for life? But I thought it's interesting what he's showing in there. And then you have this slap in the face. I came across this several times. I watched the original where these rich kids are all whinging and whining about their lives and how miserable they are being rich. It's great, yeah. So we all get sucked dry down here at the bottom, us bottom feeders, yeah. And the ones on the top are not happy with, what they've squeezed out from under us either. So that then is like a big smack in the face. So this person here, Jake Tran, is apparently he's made it. He's successful now, and he was born poor. And he's talking about this, yeah, the disgusting lives of rich kids. And his conclusion, I just want to share his conclusion with you because it's absolutely insane.
I think it can actually give you more drive, but a lot of times that's turned towards your revenge. Like, sh
So this is a rich kid who's, bemoaning his rich life.
Owning up your family, like seeing, I told you so, look what I can do. That's why you see sometimes, wealthy kids turn to drugs or you hang out with really whack job people because they want to shock their family. They want to show that they can escape from the mold that their family all seems to be a part of. I mean, personally, the way I'm going about that is because I plan to actually graduate college and go to graduate school and, thumb my nose up at them with a PhD in something. That's it. I mean, that's my little form of revenge.
Well, all that being said, there are still a very few select rich kids that do become more successful than their patriarch.
The only time that they're very successful entrepreneurs is if they have the humility to realize how difficult it is to be such a successful entrepreneur and instead go into the family business and take on the family business into the next generation. So the
'Cause they feel valueless because it's been handed down to them. They didn't have to fight for it. My husband was driven by that. He wanted to be better than his father, and it was a pipe dream that he was chasing.
Those tend to be the rich kids that actually create a lot of wealth because they can take an existing business and now, learn from it, add on to it. And that is the best thing that someone can do if they're coming from a very wealthy family, is go into the family business. There is a unique subset where essentially in their family generations and in their culture, they're forced to really be an entrepreneur since they're in elementary school. So they learn entrepreneurship from a very, very young age, and they are able to actually create businesses from scratch. And that's a very rare exception.
A great example.
Make more wealth. You haven't got enough yet. You've got enough to spend like hundreds and thousands of lifetimes. And these people, I mean, it's just, what are we in here?
All of this is how everyone's favorite billionaire George Soros is having his son take over, and how his son already has easy access to the White House. But keep it.
Wow! His son has already easy access to the White House. Did you hear that? It's so wonderful. How does that fit with this fairy tale of democracy that we're being fed? He doesn't even realize what he's saying. Oh yeah, Soros's kid takes over the family business, and he already has easy access to the White House. Isn't that marvelous? So, I was like, so I left him this comment. Oh, isn't it marvelous how Soros' son already has access to the White House? Are you not hearing what you're saying? The plebs get sold a dream of democracy where the rich buy access to power. Great world. You go chase the dollar and power whilst believing in democracy. What a joke. The rich just feed off the poor, and you call that developing business. Why is there this poverty in the first place? How about creating a world where that does not exist in the first place, but that never sort of, no, I'm poor. I have to strive. I have to become like them.
Example of this is how everyone's favorite billionaire, George Soros, is having his son take over, and how his son already has easy access to the White House.
Everybody's favorite billionaire.
Keep in mind, for every Alexander Soros there are tens of thousands of other rich kids who are complete failures. And let's be real, being the son of an actual psychopath billionaire can't be all that fun either. So what is the takeaway from all this? Is that although being born poor may feel like a curse, it's actually the biggest blessing you could have ever asked for. Because you have nowhere to go but up. Arvin was born in one of the poorest countries in the world, and then he grew up in one of the poorest communities in the US. I was born in Vietnam. We came in when I was two when we had nothing. We lived in low-income housing. I remember we would have to catch the bus and bring our own soda into McDonald's to save money and only order off the dollar menu, no combo meals. And I was so embarrassed of it growing up. But that's exactly what gave me the drive to be where I'm at today. Same with Arvin. And here's the thing. Every single inch that we ascend up the ranks of society, we get to feel every single ounce of fulfillment from it. And it's honestly the best drug in the world. But what?
It is honestly the best drug in the world. Right? It's the American dream, folks. You just rise up the ranks. Yeah? And then when you're at the top, you fall into the pit of hell and despair. So you rise up to the ranks feeling brilliant about every step of the ladder that you climb up, only to have your children end up in the misery that you created for them. I mean, it's wonderful. It's just wonderful, isn't it? Self-perpetuating hell. Best thing is how he ends it. Like the last sentence there is just, you know, perpetuate the circle, perpetuate this absolute mindless circle of chasing the money.
Every single inch that we ascend up the ranks of society, we get to feel every single ounce of fulfillment from it. And it's honestly the best drug in the world. But when you're born rich, when you're born that high up in the clouds, well, you have literally nowhere to go but down. So don't envy the rich kids. Be extremely grateful you're not one of them.
So why is he chasing it and wanting to become one? You know, he doesn't even hear what he's saying. But join him now before the spots run out. There you go. Viral profits. Special join in. Yeah. I love Johnny Cash. I'll let him have the final word.
I hurt myself today to see if I still feel. I focus on the pain. The only thing that's real. The needle tears a hole. The old familiar sting. Try to kill it all away. But I remember everything. What have sweetest friend. Everyone I